AWA Championship Wrestling. The AWA presents the greatest stars in professional wrestling, bringing you the best in mat action.
Good evening. Welcome to AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN. I'm Larry Nelson, and I'm coming at you from the AWA studios. We are not at the matches. The matches are over, so why am I here? Okay, last week we promised you the Road Warriors would defend the Tag Team Championship against Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Light Heavyweight Champion Steve Regal. We waited for the Road Warriors to show up for that match. Well after the scheduled start time we waited, they did not make it. And we found out the reason why. Their plane was grounded in Atlanta. So naturally, you're not going to see that match. You will see Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Light Heavyweight Champion Steve Regal go against Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig in a thriller of a match. And it could be that the surprise Garvin said they had for the Road Warriors, they will spring on Gagne and Hennig. Also, you'll see Sergeant Slaughter battle the big Russian Boris Zukov. Our classic match this week is Nick Bockwinkel against Rick Martel. And you'll see Larry Hennig against Scott the Hog Irwin. A lot of exciting action coming up after this.
This ESPN event is brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you.
They're America's best, America's Beach Boys.
I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California.
Now, all 18 of their greatest hits are on one album, The Beach Boys Forever.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, good.
This is the first time you can get all their hits on one record. Everybody loves the Beach Boys.
Get her out of my heart. And you'll have fun, fun, fun.
Remember, you can't buy this special album in any store. Stay tuned to order right now.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-344-1010. Or to save all COD and handling charges and pay only $8.98 for the album, $9.98 for the tape, send check or money order to Beach Boys, PO Box 2880-Z, Grand Central Station, New York, New York.
This is where it all begins, the diagram in the team's playbook.
But here's where it really comes together, in Pack Stadium on Sunday afternoon, the game on the line. That, my friend, is the real thing. And when it comes to sports coverage, the real thing for me is right here, the Sporting News.
Call this toll-free number to get in on a special half-price offer. The Sporting News delivered straight to your mailbox every week at a hefty saving.
The Sporting News delivers hard-hitting, close-up action and stats you just won't find in your local news or anywhere else. On-the-scene coverage of pro and college football, basketball, baseball, hockey, boxing, and more. 52 weeks a year.
Call toll-free 1-800-592-6000. Save one half off the regular subscription rate. You pay in three easy installments of only $4.96 each. Call now 1-800-592-6000.
Ladies and gentlemen, the action continues. Introducing, first of all, in the corner to my right, weighing 295 pounds, from Duluth, Minnesota, long rider Scott Hog Irwin. And ladies and gentlemen, in his corner, his brother and tag team partner, long rider Wild Bill Irwin. Ladies and gentlemen, in the corner to my left, weighing 303 pounds from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, here he is, Larry the Axe Hennig. Your referee, Marty Miller, down now to Rob Trongard.
Thank you, Doug, and hello again, everybody. And they hook up immediately before the sound of the bell, which you now have heard. Larry the Axe Hennig out of Robbinsdale, Minnesota. He doesn't take a back step to anybody. 330-pounder and 295-pound Scott Hog Irwin. And with me, the former champion of the world, AWA champion of the world, Vern Gagne. Nice to be back with you, Vern.
Thank you, Rod. Same here. He's a two big man again. Larry the Axe, about 340 pounds.
and they fire away. That was a right hand that hammered to the side of the head. Oh, across the ring he goes. And here comes a right hand from center field by Larry the Axe Hennig, who then drills him right in the midsection and buried that fist all the way up to his wrist.
Brother out there on the sidelines trying to harass Larry the Axe and doing a pretty good job of it. Give his brother a little bit of time to catch his wind back after it was taken out of his sails.
The Irwins, the Long Riders, one of the outstanding tag team combinations in the world, and they're right here in the AWA, the home of champions. Chokehold here. Oh, the Hog just hammers away at Larry the Axe Hennig out of Robbinsdale, Minnesota. The side headlock by the Hog. Yes, he's showing the open hand now, but it changes quickly. There you saw it. And, of course, Larry the Axe felt it. Bounces him off and gives him a right hand of his own to the forehead of the Hog, Scott Irwin. And an elbow smash right down onto the chest. And a count of one, and Larry the Axe quickly up, standing over Scott the Hog Irwin, who backs off to the ropes and, in a way, begs for mercy. They hook up again. And look at that right hand. Powerful, hard, driven right hand to the side of the head of the Hog Irwin, who has bounced off that top rope and bounces right onto the apron. Uh-oh. This will make you wish you were somewhere else.
Larry the Axe Hennig, tremendously powerful in those forearms and hands, and puts that 340 pounds behind it. I'm telling you, something's got to give. Look at that leg of Irwin's. The Hog is squealing out there.
All right, champ, I'll take that. And justifiably so. If somebody was just about twisting my leg off, I think I would too. Uh-oh, it's make-a-wish time.
Drove that knee into the thigh of Hog Irwin. And of course, when you do that, that leg, that Charlie horse starts to come in there. You aren't moving around as fast as you were before.
Scott the Hog Irwin has taken quite a bit of punishment, and he is dazed outside that ring as his brother Wild Bill Irwin, the Long Riders out of Duluth, Minnesota, talks to him.
And a little side note here on Larry the Axe Hennig. When he was in Japan, they wanted to recruit him to become a sumo wrestler. He weighs 340 pounds. He's right in that area.
And he is bounced out of the ring now by the Hog Irwin over on the far side. And the Hog Irwin goes to work with boots to the back of the head. And Larry the Axe Hennig is paying the price. And Wild Bill Irwin is encouraging his brother Scott the Hog on. And now Wild Bill himself goes to work on Larry the Axe Hennig.
The referee is distracted here by Hog Irwin. He's not watching what's going on. The attendants are over there. Look at Irwin. Hog Irwin. I mean, Scott, what's his name over there?
That's Wild
Bill.
The
Wild Bill, the wild man.
He's outside the ring.
Didn't do a thing.
On the apron is Scott Hog Irwin, working over again Larry the Axe Hennig, who has taken a lot of punishment here in the past couple of minutes. The Hog trying to get Larry the Axe back in. Twists that neck around, drapes him over the rope strand, and drills him with a hard right hand to the chest. And down goes Larry the Axe, not only to the apron, but to the floor, and bent over in bad shape. The Hog Irwin going after him, takes a boot to the head, and now suddenly Larry the Axe Hennig has Scott the Hog Irwin in a very vulnerable position and buries that right hand again in the midsection and then to a chair and into the crowd at ringside. Down onto the floor he goes, hammering away. Scott the Hog Irwin flat on his back.
Look at this.
Both of them, a head knocker as Larry the Axe Hennig does it as he takes them to the post. First of all, it was brother meet brother. head-to-head.
That post is an automatic disqualification. I don't know whether the referee caught that or not, but he seemed to be right there unless he didn't. He missed it.
Look at that. The axe going to work with the axe. I'm Scott the Hog Irwin. While Bill Irwin now taking a shoulder block from Larry the Axe Hennig, and they are both down on the floor outside of the ring. And Scott the Hog Irwin is coming now to the aid of his brother, Wild Bill Irwin. The Hog hammers away here at Larry the Axe Hennig, taking tremendous punishment. And this one, referee Marty Miller is disqualified, has thrown it out. We'll hear exactly what his decision is. But outside of the ring, they go at it. Larry the Axe Hennig first going after the Hog, and then Wild Bill. And now he has them both. The bell is sounding. This one is all over. Wild Bill Irwin hammering away on Larry the Axe. Both of the Irwins working him over. Referee Marty Miller trying to restore order, which is next to impossibility. Larry the Axe has a chair. Marty Miller is coming over now to announce his decision. A double disqualification has been announced, and that, of course, does not meet with agreement at all. As you see, Wild Bill Irwin showing his displeasure across the way and now raising the brother, the hand of his brother, Scott the Hog, as they wanted victory.
Well, Larry the Axe getting back up into the ring right now. I think he's a little bit disappointed. Had to handle two men out there. That harassment from the outside was a lot. Larry the Axe, I think you need some help over there. We should get the attendants over to help him right out here now.
Larry the Axe took a very, very severe pounding, both in and out of that ring, ladies and gentlemen, and he is stunned. Larry the Axe getting some help across the way.
For everyone working to keep the customer satisfied,
this Bud's for you. Nobody else can do the job the way you do. So here's to you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do, this Bud's for you.
Billy Margolis hated to paint. Then he found Easy Roller, the roller that feeds itself automatically. Now Billy paints a room in no time. No messy pans. He just fills the Easy Roller tank once in a while and keeps on rolling. Room after room, it's fast and it's easy.
Hey, Mitch. Mitch, do you have a room I could paint? Huh?
New Easy Roller by Easy Painter. It might make painting fun.
ESPN's exclusive Saturday Night CFA Game of the Week features flashy Heisman hopeful Reggie Dupard when Southern Methodist battles TCU in a battle of total offense leaders. The Horned Frogs counter with hard-nosed Southwest Conference-style defense. It's television's best live game of the day, only on ESPN.
Super Clash 85, an item champion, 7 p.m. September 28th, White Sox Park in Chicago. Rick Martell defends the AWA title against Stan Hansen. Rick Flair puts the NWA championship on the line against Magnum T.A. Sergeant Slaughter defends the America's crown against the Russian Boris Zukov. The Road Warriors have the tag team championship against the fabulous Freebirds. Jerry Blackwell against Kamala the Ugandan Giant in a $10,000 body slam contest. Ivan and Nikita Koloff plus Crusher Khrushchev against Nick the Bruce. The Crusher and Baron Von Raschke for the NWA six-man title. Candy Devine defends the ladies' championship against Sherry Martel. Giant Baba the Great Tenryu and Jumbo Sharuta put the six-man Asian crown on the line against the Long Riders and Harley Race. Little Tokyo defends the midget crown against Mr. T. 40 great wrestlers in all, 10 championship matches, the greatest card in history. Be there. Get your tickets now.
That was a dandy match between Larry Hennig and Scott the Hog Irwin. Now, at this time, we had planned to show you Stan the Lariat Hansen's debut in the AWA against a young man named Larry Clark. The problem was Stan Hansen's actions were so sadistic and so brutal, they were completely outside of any reasonable limit the AWA sets on good taste and on anything that we can possibly call rules. Hansen was disqualified. The match was gruesome. We cannot show it to you. I did have a chance to talk to Hansen after the match, or rather, let Hansen talk after the match. You don't get to say much when you're in the presence of Stan the Lariat Hansen. He's discussing what's going to happen this Saturday night between himself and Rick Martel in a sensational card in Chicago, Illinois. Now, we will be there, and hopefully somewhere down the road, we can bring that match with Stan Hansen and Rick Martel to you on ESPN. Hopefully, that's one you'll be able to see. But right now, let's let Stan the Lariat Hansen talk about what's going to happen next Saturday night in Chicago.
This Saturday night, Chicago, Illinois, White Sox Park, you are going to see the greatest wrestling card in history. And the man that you just saw destroy Larry Clark and get disqualified in the process is going to get a title shot.
Let me tell you something. Let me butt in here. I like to butt in on people. I've got the right. I'm 310 pounds. White Sox Park. You know, it's like I can't even comprehend it being from little old town out there in Texas. But let me tell you something. All I know is I've got my eyes fixed on you, Rick Martel, and the AWA World Championship belt. Chicago, man, that's going to be the damnedest thing you ever seen since that cow kicked over that lantern and burned it all down. Now, let me tell you something. Rick Martel, you're a champion. I'm not. So it makes me a little bit hungry. And it's Saturday night in White Sox Kaminsky Park, or however you say them wild foreign names. I'm coming in there Saturday night, brother, and I'm bringing this big, nasty bull rope, and I'm bringing this nasty lariat. Stan Hansen, a hungry boy from Texas. A lot of people can relate with that. I didn't have no rich. I come from the bottom. Saturday night in Chicago, brother, I'm coming after it. I'm bringing this bell. Ring that bell. Everybody across the park's going to be ringing a big cowbell because they know I'm the biggest, the nastiest, the toughest dog that walks the round. I'm the number one Texan. And that in itself is great bragging rights. Rick Martel, pay heed. People of Chicago, pay heed. The bell's coming. The lariat's coming. Saturday night. AWA World Championship. It's getting on the plane out there in O'Hare and heading south to Texas. Stan Hansen, the biggest, the nastiest, the fastest.
Stan Hansen coming to Chicago to take on Rick Martel this coming Saturday night.
If I look scared during that segment, it is because I was. I firmly believe that Stan the Lariat Hansen is crazy. All right? You're going to see Sergeant Slaughter battle it out with Boris Zukov soon. We'll be right back.
Look how water can destroy unprotected wood, but not if it's protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Use Thompson's Water Seal waterproofer on dozens of surfaces. Brush on Thompson's for an invisible barrier that helps prevent water from entering and damaging brick, wood, and concrete. Your house isn't really protected until it's protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Many stores now have special values on Thompson's Water Seal.
Our brick house keeps the wolf out.
But to keep out the huffing and puffing of winter,
we use Thompson's Easy Weatherproofers. They're so easy because there's no caulking gun.
Easy Caulker has silicone to last and last.
Thompson's Easy Insulator Foam fills large cracks, expanding 25 times to form a permanent seal.
Come spring, Easy Weather Stripper peels off.
So seal your place with Thompson's, whether it's brick,
wood,
or even straw. Thompson's Easy Products, the foolproof weather...
The AWA takes the greatest wrestlers in the world on tour September 25th, Queens, New York. Larry Zbyszko and the Long Riders. September 26th in Atlantic City, ESPN taping at the Tropicana. Stan Hansen, the Freebirds, the Road Warriors, all the great stars. September 27th in Seatucket, the Long Riders and Boris Zukov.
September 28th, Superclash 85, the Night of Champions comes to Chicago at White Sox Park. 10 title matches, 40 of the greatest wrestlers in the world. September 29th in St. Paul, the Fall Classic. The Road Warriors, Jerry Blackwell, the Freebirds, and Rick Martel. In Denver, October 2nd, Greg Gagne, Larry Zbysko, and all three Freebirds. Los Angeles, October 4th, a Battle Royal, 20 men fight for $100,000. In Milwaukee, October 5th, the Road Warriors, Kamala the Ugandan Giant, and Stan Hansen. October 6th in Janesville, Wisconsin, a Battle Royal, Jerry Blackwell and Kamala the Ugandan Giant involved. October 7th, Monday, Rochester, Minnesota, Mayo Civic Auditorium, the Road Warriors, Boris Zukov, and the Long Riders. The AWA is coming your way.
Listen closely, my friends, to this tale of international commerce, intrigue, and diamonds. A spectacular, multifaceted, genuine diamond ring. The diamond surrounded by six genuine dialites and set in pure 14-karat layered gold. Genuine diamond earrings, multifaceted genuine diamonds, also surrounded by sparkling dialites and set in pure 14-karat layered gold. You can have both the ring and the earrings for only $19.95. Schreiber and Moore Jewelers purchased an enormous shipment in the Orient at tremendous discount. So now you can have both for only $19.95. And
if you pay by check or credit card, you'll get free this matching pendant. It's free if you order by check or credit card.
Call 1-800-852-5555 to get a free pendant and chain, plus save COD charges. Use your credit card or send $19.95 plus $205 shipping and handling to Diamond Offer. Box 2838, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. Please specify ring size.
The Olympic dream starts young, but it's going to take your dollars to turn his dream into gold.
You believe in miracles? Yes!
For a $10 tax-deductible contribution, you can support the 1988 Olympic team and receive this USA Olympic belt buckle. Send to Olympic Buckle, Colorado Springs, Colorado. Turn the dream into gold.
This Bud's for everyone who puts the roads on the map.
This Bud's for you, for all you do. The king of beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do, for you.
Someday, we're Auto Racing's number one network with NASCAR's Holly Farms 400. It's worth more than $200,000. Live Sunday.
Here we are with Sergeant Slaughter, and you saw what happened. Everybody dreams of a title shot, the NWA title on the line. You had Ric Flair, obviously, where you wanted him. You had the Cobra clutch on him. All of a sudden, the Russian interfered.
Boris Zukov, you scum, you slime, you maggot. All my life in sports, I tried to be the best, and I worked hard at being number one. And when I got into professional wrestling, that was my goal, to be a champion. And I went, and I beat everybody there was, and I had to leave one organization because a champ was a chump, and he wouldn't give me a match. Well, Flair, you gave me the match for the NWA title. And I had you beat. I put the Cobra clutch on you, and I heard you giving up. It was all over. And the next thing I know, I looked at this bald, big man trying to bust my head wide open, trying to leave me laying, send me to a hospital. Well, let me tell you, I've been pretty easy lately. But now I have a reason to go back to war. And I'm declaring war on you, Boris Zukov. War like you've never seen it before. Everybody's imitating Sergeant Slaughter these days. There's corporals, there's Rambos, but there's only one Sergeant Slaughter, and I represent the USA. I'm gonna get rid of you, commie.
Sergeant Slaughter and Boris Zukov go to war next, right here on ESPN.
This Bud's for all you guys who know it's how you play the game.
This Bud's for you. There's no one else who makes them move the way you do.
Come your way.
So here's to you. What are you going to do?
King of Beers is coming through.
Yeah, just for you. That distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
For all you do. It's Bud's for you.
When people work, chances are they're wearing Dickies. It's the best-selling work set in America. And if you need coveralls, overalls, work gloves, socks, or shirts, footwear, headgear, underwear, or outerwear, they all have Dickies horseshoe label. Dickies are America's favorite work clothes. But who says you have to work in them? Dickies. Made with Celanese Fortrel polyester.
Introducing an amazing new tool designed to help you work in those hard-to-get-at spots the conventional tools can't, the Cricut. The versatile Cricut is a ratchet screwdriver as well as a ratchet wrench. In those hard-to-get-at tight spots where other wrenches won't work, the amazing Cricut at Squeeze Ratchet Action does the job with ease, saving time, temper, and skinned knuckles. No more impossible jobs, not with the Cricut. It features a reversible push-through drive, turning power six times the gripping force. Can be used with any standard Dometric 3/8 inch socket and much, much more. Solidly made in America of high alloy steel with lifetime guarantee. If you order today, not only receive the incredible Cricut, but for a limited time only, also receive five slotted screwdriver bits, five Phillips bits, a quarter-inch drive socket adapter, and an anvil that adapts to any 3/8 inch drive, plus a sturdy storage box. All 14 pieces, only $19.99.
To order your 14-piece Cricut ratchet set with a lifetime guarantee and made in America quality, use your credit card for rush delivery by calling toll-free 1-800-331-1000. Or send check or money order for only $19.99 plus $3 shipping and handling to Cricut Ratchet, P.O. Box 3500, Department A, West Caldwell, New Jersey.
Jacket on, or coat, or whatever he calls that garb. Across the ring he comes, and a tremendous elbow smash, and he's flat on his back again, and out of the ring and going to the aid of his manager, Chris Markov. Oh, what a start here, Vern Gagne.
It certainly is. Doug McLeod, our announcer, not even had a chance to for introductions. I guess the match is going. Referee seems to be counting, and it's in progress. Sergeant Slaughter versus Boris Zukov. You can't stop. There's no good feeling here between these two people.
No two ways about that. And another tremendous blow by Sergeant Slaughter, who takes his belt off and wraps it around the neck of Boris Zukov and takes him to the ropes.
And into the ropes.
Look at that. Into the neck goes the combat belt of Sergeant Slaughter that is taken to ringside now by referee Jim Mitchell. And Sergeant Slaughter goes to work with a side headlock and drilled Zukov in the head 10 times with that right fist.
It didn't seem to faze Zukov. He has that unusually large, hard head. We've seen boards broken over that head. His manager, Markov, Chris Markov, watching from the sideline. Zukov, a tremendously strong head. The Sarge knows it, blocks it.
Both men exchange punches. Both hard right hands, and it's Zukov that backs away. Look at the drop kick. Sergeant Slaughter pointing over to Vern Gagne saying, I learned that from you, when he couldn't have learned it from anyone any better than the former heavyweight champion of the world, my colleague here at ringside here tonight in this tremendous AWA All-Star show that is going all across the world to the Meadowlands. Look at that. Look at that reversal and up and over the top rope. There is no disqualification here. That could be disqualification, but it was ruled that momentum carried him over and not actually Sergeant Slaughter forcing him over that top rope or doing it deliberately.
It was not deliberate. That's right.
The Meadowlands, the Horizon in Chicago, Denver, Colorado, the Salt Palace in Salt Lake City, the Riviera in Las Vegas, Anchorage, Alaska, Honolulu, Hawaii, Winnipeg, Canada, Puerto Rico, wherever you go, you see the greatest in all-star wrestling from the AWA and ESPN. Oh, and there they go at each other again as they flail away, and Sergeant Slaughter drills him with a hard right hand that puts him on the canvas, and then the sergeant goes to work with a chokehold on the neck, and referee Jim Mitchell forces him to break it. Wow! What a war out there.
It is a war tonight. Rod Krongard, the referee trying to control Sergeant Slaughter, but he has no idea, no love for this man right here. Boris Zhukov with the size 10 and a half or 12. I'm talking about his head. Huge. The Sarge has to go to the jaw. He cannot hit that head.
Like, oh, look at that. An elbow smashed in the back of the head of Sergeant Slaughter. And it is believed that Zhukov slipped something into that elbow pad. Sergeant Slaughter went down like he had been shot from a gun. And there it is again.
The referee should check that elbow pad.
Referee Jim Mitchell, watching, has not checked the right elbow pad yet. There it is again to the head of Sergeant Slaughter, and down he goes again. Sergeant Slaughter being gone over now by Boris Zhukov. Slaughter in a bad, bad way, as you can see. And again, at least 10 times, Sergeant Slaughter hammered to the head with the elbow with some foreign object believed in that right elbow pad. And now Zhukov rakes his hand across the eyes of the sergeant out of Paris Island, South Carolina, the author of the Cobra Corps. He's going to have to reach back here, or it may be curtains for Sergeant Slaughter. The crowd comes to life and the chant of USA.
He keeps hammering with that elbow. Undoubtedly, there is something there. Now, a fist driven in, the referee trying to stop him.
Sergeant Slaughter trying to get it back. Oh, he drills him with the right hand, and Slaughter fires away with a right of his own, takes one in the midsection, and Sergeant Slaughter takes a boot to the midsection and then takes a punch, three or four of them, one downstairs and two upstairs from Boris Zhukov. Referee Jim Mitchell is counting on Zhukov, and Sergeant Slaughter drills him hard with a hard right hand. Again a forehand. Again a gigantic right hand. And two lefts to the side of the head. Four times he goes to the side of the head. And there's a crushing right hand that sends Zhukov flat on his back.
Zhukov. He did go to the jaw, Rod. He did go to the jaw. He stayed away from that head. I'm talking about Slaughter. And he put him down with it. He's got to keep going that way.
Direct.
There he goes.
Directly above us, he hammers away now at Zhukov. Zhukov, still in the corner. Slaughter whips him all the way across from corner to corner, and here's the big back body drop. Zhukov, 7 feet up in the air, and now the sergeant says, maybe I've got something in my elbow pad. Let's see, the clothesline, and down goes Zhukov, a cover here. Hard right hand, a trio of them here by Sergeant Slaughter. Slaughter hammering away. Jim Mitchell is pushed off by Sergeant Slaughter. Mitchell the referee, and again Sergeant Slaughter does an arm drag takedown type move, and across the ring goes Mitchell. Here comes Chris Markoff.
Oh, look at this.
Sergeant Slaughter has been disqualified. Referee Jim Mitchell announcing.
Are you sure it's Slaughter disqualified? Markoff was in that ring. I don't know who got disqualified here first.
We'll have
the
to find out.
The Sarge wants
sure.
a piece of him. He wants a piece of a Markoff trying to pull his boy out of there. The Sarge going out after him. Mitchell hanging on as hard as he can. A boot lane in the ring that someone threw in or he took off.
and the crowd chanting USA. Referee Jim Mitchell continuing to hang on to Sergeant Slaughter, who wants Boris Zhukov and Chris Markov both back in that ring.
Right, Chris Markov said the Russians are coming before. Looks like the Russians are going now. And here's Sergeant, ready for more. I'd like to hear from the referee. What was it?
As we mentioned to you, Sergeant Slaughter being disqualified for interference in the match and really working over referee Jim Mitchell.
Well, when he threw a 300-pound Jim Mitchell with one arm across the ring, you know the power of that man, Sergeant Slaughter. He impressed me, but he was disqualified for that effort, but I really can't say that I blame him. The man worked him over with fists earlier. The Sarge came back. If he had just played a little bit more cool, he'd have probably had this match. But nothing has been finished here tonight with this match, except we know one thing. The Sarge, Slaughter, is still a very, very hot man.
Absolutely. He got a little bit out of control, went a bit too far, and it cost him. We'll be right back.
You've just settled in for a relaxing weekend at home, and you need help now. Call the friendly folks at Ekstrom's for all of your plumbing, electrical, and hardware needs. They'll show you how to fix things right. Ekstrom's, where price wins friends and quality keeps them.
Sanborn Chevrolet is clearing them out for 85. It's Sanborn Chevrolet's year-end closeout sale. Save now like you never have before on Sanborn Chevrolet's large selection of new cars and trucks. Sanborn Chevrolet is clearing them out for 85. So if you've been waiting for that super deal on a new Chevrolet car or truck, now is the time during Sanborn Chevrolet's year-end closeout sale. Plus, get 7.7 financing on selected models. Where else? Sanborn Chevrolet in Lodi.
All right, it is obvious that the issue is not settled between Sergeant Slaughter and Boris Zhukov. I know we're going to hear more from those two later, but right now we want to focus on the Mountain from Stone Mountain, Georgia, 472-pound Jerry Blackwell, one of the greatest wrestlers in the world. He was a competitor in the ABC television strongman competition. My buddy, my broadcast partner, Ken Resnick, who's an announcer for Pro Wrestling USA, had a chance to see Jerry Blackwell in action doing some incredible things. We want to show you that tape right now.
All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, we're here with big 472-pound Jerry Blackwell. Now, you wrestling fans have all seen Jerry Blackwell and that big power smash in action. You've seen what it can do to opponents. Jerry Blackwell has asked us here. Jerry, I understand you intend to show just how devastating that power smash is.
That's right. This is a 2-inch thick board, 12 inches long and 12 inches wide. And I'm using this as protection from the splinters from the board. What? I'm going to try to splash that and break it. I want to show everybody the exact effect my splash has on people.
Now, wait, you intend to break this 2x4 just using your power smash?
Not a 2x4, it's a 2x12. Yes, I'm going to try my best.
All right, well, fans, I'm just going to... All right, wrestling fans, you saw it. Jerry Blackwell, 472 pounds. Take a look just exactly what this board looked like after the big man gave it the splash.
And I'm going to give a lot of people the same thing.
Wrestling fans, you just saw it. Jerry Blackwell, the power body smash. All right, Jerry Blackwell, there is no doubt everyone saw what that power body smash did to this board. It's obvious the kind of effect it has on your opponents, but now, Jerry, do I understand this right, that you intend, not with a nail, but with this steel spike, to drive it through this board? You can see how thick it is with your head.
You see any holes in the board?
Not a hole. Solid.
So the only way to get it through there is to drive it through, right, Ken?
Exactly.
You have to take it. I use this rag to sort of help to protect the skin, and I'm going to attempt, I hope I can do it, to headbutt it through the board. I think it's through there, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you saw it all the way through. There's already some blood beginning to come through your forehead.
That's right. But when I do this, I do it for one reason. I want all those people out there that's been trying to do a lot of things to me to know how hard my head is. It's okay if I spill a little blood, but I'm going to spill some on other people too.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you saw it. There is no doubt as to the hardness of the head of Big Jerry Blackwell. Now what do you... All right, wrestling fans.
A lot of people, y'all just watch and you see. Because you see how hard the head is. You see how much the splash hurts. And there's a lot more where that comes from.
I have never, ever seen anything like Jerry Blackwell, like what you just saw. We've got In This Corner, Larry Zbyszko's program, featuring Greg Gagne this week, coming up next.
Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Liberace, with a special 40th anniversary concert performance with the world-renowned London Philharmonic Orchestra. All the magic, all the music of this historic anniversary performance has been captured on this unique two-record set, Liberace's 40th anniversary album. This collection includes classic concert performances from Tchaikovsky to Beethoven, Chopin to Rachmaninoff, as well as contemporary favorites from Gershwin's I Got Rhythm to New York, New York. You'll get more than 40 classic performances, more than 90 entertaining minutes on two records or long play cassette. Liberace and the London Philharmonic, the 40th anniversary collection, available only if you order now.
Credit card and COD customers, call toll-free 800-358-5858. That's 800-358-5858. Or save COD fees by sending $11.98 to Liberace, P.O. Box 2880, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. That's Liberace, P.O. Box 2880, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. Please specify records, 8-track, or cassette tape.
To everyone who loves the thrill of Grand National Racing, Budweiser is coming at you with Double Thunder. NASCAR legend Junior Johnson leads two of the hottest teams to hit the circuit.
This Bud's for you, for all you do, that king of beers is coming true.
The Junior Johnson Budweiser Chevys are roaring your way with Double Thunder.
For all you do,
this Bud's for you.
Thursday, Auto Racing 85 includes the World Championship Demolition Derby and Figure 8 competition from New York. Thursday on ESPN.
More exciting matches coming up later on. Right now, time for In This Corner, hosted by Mr. Larry Zbyszko and your guest this week, none other than Greg Gagne, twice a member of the tag team champions of the AWA, a leading contender for Rick Martel's heavyweight championship, master of the sleeper hold and the dropkick.
Well, he's an accomplished athlete, but I've recognized and I've seen symptoms of some hidden psychological problems. And that's what I'm going to try to get out of Greg Gagne today and find out what really makes him tick. Right now, I want you people to watch a video now of Greg at Camp Slaughter and see if you can pick out what I picked out about the man's hidden psychological problems.
Welcome to Camp Slaughter. I want all you wrestlers to pay attention, because Sergeant Slaughter has a new recruit. And whenever we get in the ring, you never know where we might be coming from. Hit it! It's the enemy! enemy. That's the enemy. You love me, don't you?
I hate you, Spider.
You love me, don't you?
I hate you.
Can you imagine what's going to happen to our opponents? This is war.
I hate you.
All right, I like it. Throw it. Throw it.
And now you at least have a little bit of an idea what Greg Gagne went through at Camp Slaughter. Greg, the logical question is, you're an accomplished wrestler. You are a top contender for the heavyweight championship. Why did you choose to put yourself through that kind of torture?
Well, it wasn't torture, Larry. It's just it comes to a point in any athlete's life. I don't care if you're a professional football player, basketball player, baseball player, when you're a little complacent with yourself. And I think possibly that's what happened to me in my wrestling style for the last few months. And I needed something. I needed Sergeant Slaughter to take me back out in the field, give me that little extra, that little kick in the butt that I needed to change me around. It added a little new dimension to my wrestling style. I haven't changed my style, just added a new dimension to it, and that's what Slaughter did for me.
Are you trying to kid us, or do you expect me, at least, with the intelligence I have, to believe that crock that you just dished out? You know, I said to these people, Greg...
It doesn't make any difference to me what you believe, Larry.
Well, hey, you know what? At least you're not dressed like a shrub like Sergeant is. You have a little bit of class to you. But I guess that probably falls into the question I'm going to ask you. For these people at home, answer this. It seems to me, from what I've noticed, growing up in the shadow of a father who's supposed to be so great...
Well, he was a great wrestler.
...that someone like you, who's a good wrestler... obviously has grown up with an inferiority type of complex.
I don't have an
I've noticed
complex.
It. I know. That's the first sign of it. You know what I mean? I've noticed, and this is a reality, that you've hidden behind your father. You've hidden behind a partner.
I don't hide.
And it's very coincidental.
I'm not hiding right
it's
now.
It's very coincidental that you're hiding behind Sergeant Slaughter. When your father retired, you got out a new father figure in Sergeant Slaughter, and you're hiding behind him. The true
First of all, I don't have an inferiority complex.
Certainly.
Second of all, I don't hide behind anyone.
Well, of course
I go out and wrestle a man like Nick Bockwinkel. We had matches around the country here, one-on-one. There was people like yourself, Ray the Crippler Stevens, interfered in matches. Not you, not Nick Bockwinkel, not myself,
okay,
anybody can wrestle to...
Now.
People at one time.
I'm trying to be nice.
Look, so I went out and I found myself a partner, Sergeant Slaughter, the man who defeated you for the America's title.
That's what I'm saying. Let me ask you this. Is there going to come a day when Greg Gagne is going to grow up and stand on his own 2 feet without his daddy, without a partner, without Sergeant Slaughter?
Well,
do you have to go in a ring wearing a camouflage outfit? Who are you trying to pretend to be? And what is a real Greg Gagne?
I'm not trying to pretend
I know
to be
it's
anybody.
Hard
I'm
growing up with a silver spoon, with daddy selecting your matches. But come on, be honest, Greg,
well,
and grow
up. Well, let me finish.
Up.
Let me talk.
But say something intelligent.
I'm going to if you
the
let
sergeant
me talk.
Isn't behind you working the streets. Can you speak?
Who's working yours?
No obviously. One's
okay,
working my
is,
skin.
I'm
my
own. You're looking at Greg Gagne on In This Corner.
Obviously, the man is, has a serious problem, and would you have...
America's best, America's beach boys.
I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California.
Now, all 18 of their greatest hits are on one album, The Beach Boys Forever.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, good.
This is the first time you can get all their hits on one record. Everybody loves the Beach Boys. Remember, you can't buy this special album in any store. Stay tuned to order right now.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-344-1010. Or to save all COD and handling charges and pay only $8.98 for the album, $9.98 for the tape. Send check or money order to Beach Boys. P.O. Box 2880-Z, Grand Central Station, New York, New York.
Don't be a victim of the past. Be a part of the future now.
See the newest Schick Total Touch electronic shaver with lightning charge. The newest Schick Total Touch electronic shaver with lightning charge. Charges in less than half an hour. A new standard for shavers now. All Schick shavers feature Total Touch technology. Schick, the civilized shaver. Use it and love it, or your money back. Schick and Lady Schick. They're everything we say, or your money back.
Soon these streets will be teeming with people, all going after the American dream of success, just like you. Perhaps you should subscribe to the Wall Street Journal before they get here.
Call 800-372-3000 for this new journal offer. 13 weeks for just $28 with a money-back guarantee. 13 weeks, $28. Phone 800-372-3000 now for the Wall Street Journal.
Well, it's obvious from this week's segment of In This Corner that Greg Gagne and Larry Zbysko are not going to exchange Christmas cards this year. Right now, we want to go to a very special part of our broadcast. We like to take classic matches. We like to take unusual matches featuring the greatest stars from all over the world, and each week bring you something very, very special. This week, we're going to go back to January 16th, 1983. The heavyweight champion of the world was Nick Bockwinkel, and this night, he will defend his title against a very determined young Canadian named Rick Martel. Now, let's go to the Civic Center in St. Paul.
All the marbles at stake. Nick Bockwinkel on the bottom on his belly and on top of him with a side headlock. Rick Martel, the challenger from Quebec City, Canada. Quebec City, Quebec. Bockwinkel knows all the tricks. He probably could rewrite the book. Son of Warren Bockwinkel, who in his day was a world heavyweight champion. Mr. Humble, Mr. Bockwinkel. If you buy that, I got some land in Florida I'll sell you real cheap. Humility, he doesn't know the meaning of the word. Oh, he knows the meaning, but he won't. Look at this, look at this. Hey, Martel! Like scrubbing clothes in a washboard. Hip lock takedown from a side headlock into the head, sends his Bockwinkel and both men up. Left side of your screen, Heenan. Bockwinkel's manager upset. Oh, yeah. Martel, boy, he's got everything at stake here. And so does Bockwinkel. Martel earned the right to this match through the championship committee, of which Stanley Blackburn, the president of the AWA, is a member. Throw off by Bockwinkel, catches him on the way back. Bill Crow pick out Martel. Bockwinkel stops him. Here comes a body slam, you bet. Kick out again, Martel. Martel landed properly. Bockwinkel on that body slam. He tries for a kick out like Martel did and missed. The timing was off. Hip lock takedown. Into the head scissors. Bockwinkel, both men up. Quick hip. Side headlock again. And Heenan. Score! Heenan one, chairs nothing. Heenan just creamed a chair. The only justice to the thing is that he's going to have to pay $27 for the chair he just smashed in. Or $32, whatever they're up to. Martel in tip-top shape, as usual, as is Bockwinkle. Bockwinkle with a few more hash marks on his body, maybe, than Martel. But Bockwinkle works out diligently. He takes three. So this is my body. I'm going to take care of it. Works out maybe 30, 45 minutes before he enters the match. So that all the joints and the muscles are stretched and supple. Martel not going to get a pin with the side headlock, but he's going to deter Bockwinkle from perpetrating something. Maybe not. Bockwinkle caught him with the knee and the guts coming off the rope. You got to get a guy a little bit low to flip him over like that. And if you get him a little bit low, you got him where it hurts. There's an uppercut, open hand, maybe. Referee was right there. I would assume that it's an open hand. Irish whip into the rope. And then he again. And Bockwinkle going for a pin one. And Martel quickly and wisely getting out of it. He didn't wait for the count of two to get an extra breath. Oh, look out. Here comes a pile driver. This has won many a match for Bockwinkle. He's unable to. No! He was unable to get Martel up, but Martel may have hurt his back trying to get Bockwinkle over. Oh, got him right on the ear. And that hurts. That's a big out. A flying body block. One, two, and Bockwinkle. Unbowed and unbeaten so far in this match, right? There are photographers all around this ring from all the major magazines, sporting magazines all over the country. Japan, Mexico, some of the local and area television station crews, camera crews are here. This auditorium is packed. Wrestling enjoying a tremendous interest, renaissance, if you wish to call it that. There's never been any waiting interest, but boy, they just keep packing more people in the auditoriums all over the world. Not just here. Heenan protesting to the timekeeper and ring steward and ring announcer, Al DeRusche, I think. That's to no avail. It's just a study in frustration when they do that. When I have announced been ring announcer and sit ringside, and they'll either the people or the wrestlers will take, and give you some guff, and there's nothing you can do about it. You're just doing your job. Out of one, two. Oh, Martel had to get out of that one. You better not take too much time in between. Why is he waiting? Why is he waiting? I don't know. There's a reason. A double sledgehammer in the rib cage. Another one on the side of the ribs. Lying knee drop right in the small of the back. Jim Mitchell, referee, I guess, off because Bockwinkle's leg's out on that bottom rope. Called for the break. You got it. Now, don't trust Bockwinkle. He's got something up his sleeve. Oh, well, maybe not. Martel double sledging him, and a kick in the back, a kick in the scapula, the shoulder blades, the rhomboid, trapezius, he's got them all. All right, one, two, oh, and Bockwinkel got that right shoulder up and got out of it. Remember, this is for the World Heavyweight Championship. The AWA, held by Vic Bockwinkel, the champion. Martel wants it. It means lots of scratch, baby. Lots of scratch. Lots of prestige. There comes the body slam. Oh, and Bockwinkel, Latin. I'll tell you, Heenan doesn't want Bockwinkel to lose. Because if he does, there goes his meal ticket. One, two, oh! He almost lost the whole works right there. Oh, the octopus, a submission hold. Martel on, has Bockwinkel all tied up. Bockwinkel shaking his head no. Heenan screaming some instructions across the ring. Now Heenan up into the ring, gets the referee over there. And Bockwinkel able to swing that left hand around, and I think he got Martel in the eyes. He's going to throw him right out of the ring, and the referee's arguing with Heenan. Oh, Martel comes back in. Bockwinkel went over. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Just a cotton picking minute. The referee rings the bell. Listen. If you heard it or not, did they hear that clearly, Kirk? I'm talking to our sound engineer. All right, Martel is disqualified for having thrown Nick Bockwinkel over the top rope. If you saw Bockwinkel threw Martel over the top rope and then him turned around, Martel threw Bockwinkel and he got caught. Wait a minute, what's happening here? Look out! Martel cleaning house on Bockwinkel and Heenan, both of them. Piled him right into the ring post. Flying drop kick on Bockwinkel. The match is over. Martel disqualified. Bockwinkel still champion. Excuse me. Well, here it is. Now, what is going on? Oh, Bockwinkel is just on rubber legs. 3D's down. Look out, Martel, right after Heenan and Bockwinkel some more. Martel will not be denied. He's madder than... is he mad? Heenan hung up on the top rope over the side. Bockwinkel getting body slammed. Martel better just as well save it. The match is officially over. Martel is disqualified. Martel, absolute frustration showing. I'm sure you can understand his feelings. He's disqualified. Bockwinkel retains the championship. I don't see Bockwinkel. I don't see Heenan, but the match is over, and that's the way she ended right here on All-Star Wrestling.
Somehow, some way, Nick Bockwinkel managed to hang on to the heavyweight championship of the world, the challenge from Rick Martel. Now, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and light heavyweight champion Steve Regal thought they would be going into the ring against the Road Warriors tonight. It was not to be. We will talk to them when we come back.
Hobson's Bicycle Centers have everything for the beginning and serious cyclist.
Specialized bikes, Bridgestone and Miata. A complete line of equipment, touring bags, safety helmets, shoes, cyclo computers, and a wide selection of clothes, including winter clothes for all-weather cycling. Hobson's qualified staff can give you expert advice and can perform quality repairs to keep your bike in top condition. With two locations, at 429B West Lockerford Street in Lodi and 1728 West Hammer Lane in the Parkwood Center, Stockton.
You've been warned by stories in the news. Be careful where you buy your used car. Stockton Nissan is a high-volume new car dealer. 8 years in a row, Nissan's award winner for excellence in all departments. Stockton Nissan carries the highest reputation a car dealer can possess. Volume dealing means more used cars taken in trade, serviced legally. Therefore, a finer selection for you to choose from at a better price. North Wilson Way at the dealing end of town. Stockton Nissan, where we service well what we sell.
Super Clash 85, an item champion, 7 p.m. September 28th, White Sox Park in Chicago. Rick Martell defends the AWA title against Stan Hansen. Ric Flair puts the NWA championship on the line against Magnum T.A. Sergeant Slaughter defends the America's crown against the Russian Boris Zukov. The Road Warriors have the tag team championship against the fabulous Freebirds. Jerry Blackwell against Kamala the Ugandan Giant in a $10,000 body slam contest. Ivan and Nikita Koloff, plus Crusher Khrushchev against Nick the Bruce. The Crusher and Baron Von Raschke for the NWA six-man title. Candy Devine defends the ladies' championship against Sherry Martel. Giant Baba the Great Tenryu and Jumbo Sharuta put the six-man Asian crown on the line against the Long Riders and Harley Race. Little Tokyo defends the midget crown against Mr. T. 40 great wrestlers in all, 10 championship matches. The greatest card in history. Be there. Get your tickets now.
Strength, pride, tradition. For centuries, the Clydesdales have been known as a special breed. Today, the Clydesdales symbolize Budweiser's dedication to quality, superior ingredients, exclusive Beechwood aging, and a distinctively clean, crisp taste only Budweiser can offer. Quality taste, because this Bud's for you.
In 1914, Isuzu lost the first car race in Japan to a horse. Today, Isuzu's turbo impulse is getting even.
All week long, everybody here at ESPN has been wondering about this next match. The Road Warriors defending the tag team title against gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and light heavyweight champion Steve Regal. Everybody at ESPN wondering just exactly, you guys say you have something up your sleeve. You say you have some sort of master plan. You're going straight from here to the ring with the Road Warriors.
This guy don't shut up, does he? He must be plugged into something. I mean, next thing you know, he's probably going to say, well, what is your surprise, right?
What is your surprise?
And expecting us to tell him.
Tell him, right?
You got to be kidding me.
The fact is, I got to tell you, you are looking real fine, Mr.
Electricity. Oh, you too, gorgeous. You're looking beautiful, baby.
And I think that when we're the new world heavyweight champions, we're going to look even finer.
Oh, yes, right. With those belts around our waist.
That's
oh.
Right. Well, I'm not afraid of that paint and
no,
stuff.
No, no, that
and
doesn't
all that
scare
muscle
us.
Don't scare
hey,
us.
Hey, we're not just another couple pretty faces, ladies and gentlemen. We got some brains up here, and we got something up our sleeve for the Road Warriors. Everybody wants to know what it is. But
in just a few short minutes,
they're going to find out.
The whole
out.
World's
the
going
whole
to
world.
Find out.
Mr. Electricity and gorgeous Jimmy are going to shock the wrestling
and
world.
And guess what? It's not going to be our fault either.
That's right.
Just
that's
like
right.
It's not our fault. We're the greatest looking wrestlers in the world. It's not going to be our fault. We're the new world tag team champions.
And would we lie to you, ladies and gentlemen? Would we ever lie to anybody?
We would never lie.
Never, ever.
Coming up next, the Road Warriors against gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Steve Regal.
Right now, you're looking good. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and light heavyweight champion Steve Regal thought they had a surprise for the Road Warriors. As it turned out, fate had a surprise for Garvin and Regal in the form of Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig. We'll see that match after this.
Listen closely, my friends, to this tale of international commerce, intrigue, and
diamonds. A spectacular, multifaceted, genuine diamond ring. The diamond surrounded by six genuine dialites and set in pure 14-karat layered gold. Genuine diamond earrings, multifaceted genuine diamonds, also surrounded by sparkling dialites and set in pure 14-karat layered gold. You can have both the ring and the earrings for only $19.95. Schreiber and Moore Jewelers purchased an enormous shipment in the Orient at tremendous discount. So now you can have both for only $19.95. And
if you pay by check or credit card, you'll get free this matching pendant. It's free if you order by check or credit card.
Call 1-800-852-5555 to get a free pendant and chain, plus save COD charges, use your credit card, or send $19.95 plus $205 shipping and handling to Diamond Offer, Box 2838, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. Please specify ring size.
Thursday night, auto racing's number one network delivers again. ESPN's Speed Week team sets an unbeatable primetime pace with television's most relied-on motorsports report. Next, the ultimate fender bender. World Championship demolition derby clashes and smashes mean bone-jarring collision-packed thrills. Then we're smoking at the IHRA Summer Nationals. Raiders, funny cars, pro stocks, we've got them all in a blistering day at the drag. ESPN is the driving force Thursday.
Gentlemen, this is a tag team battle. Introducing in the ring at this time, in the corner to my right, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Accompanied, as always, by his valet, Precious. His tag team partner, ladies and gentlemen, weighing 218 pounds from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, the AWA light heavyweight champion of the world, Mr. Electricity, Steve Regal. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Garvin and Regal were scheduled to face the Road Warriors tonight. However, we have just learned the flight they were to take has been canceled from Atlanta.
Hey, let me tell you something. You can tell these people anything you want to, pal. But the fact is, Mr. Electricity and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, I guess, are the new world champions because we're not afraid to show up.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a sensational tag team to face gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Steve Regal. And these two men have volunteered to step into this match to take on gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Mr. Electricity, Steve Regal. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, now approaching the ringside area. And what a tag team this is. Introducing now as they enter the ring, weighing 235 pounds, from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, part of the Axe Attack, Kurt Hennig. Kurt Hennig. And ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner from Mound, Minnesota, weighing 218 pounds, Greg Gagne. Your referee, Jim Mitchell, down now to Rod Trungar.
Well, here we go, Greg Gagne and Kurt Hennig, opponents for Jimmy Garvin and
Mr. Electricity Steve Regal, and the fight is on. And a tremendous right hand by Gagne sends gorgeous Jimmy Garvin reeling to the canvas and out of the ring. Both Garvin and Regal are outside the ring as Greg Gagne and Kurt Hennig took immediately control right from the outset here, Byrne.
I tell you, Kurt Hennig is awfully angry here with pressures out of which, but I know Kurt Hennig was almost pulling that fist back. I don't think he'd have done it, but pressure stood right there, stood her ground to him. This is something else. The road war.
Part of the tremendous action. The tremendous action that you see here, the very best of professional wrestling in the AWA on ESPN. Cover, quick cover by Gagne after the body slam. Headset, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin crashing to the canvas. Gagne. Now, and the light heavyweight champion of the world, Steve Regal. Arm drag, takedown, and down goes Regal. Gagne tags off, and in comes Kurt Hennig. Kurt Hennig with an armbar now on the light heavyweight champion. Regal and Garvin teaming up here on All-Star Wrestling. Oh, tremendous shoulder block by the light heavyweight champion. And what is this? The action is fast and furious, and you had Kurt Hennig waiting in ambush there for the light heavyweight champion and taking him down to that canvas and now has him wrapped up in an armbar.
What a tremendous arm drag by Kurt Hennig when he caught Regal coming off those ropes. That mat looked like it was in a break in two. He went so far down into it.
Regal having tagged off with gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, and he has a front face lock.
That referee better get down there, check that front face lock. It looks from here, Rod, you can see it, like this might be across the throat.
It looked like it was across the throat. Referee Jim Mitchell says no. It's a legal hold. Oh, a full leg rush. However, it does not break the hold, and they're back where they started from, the center of the ring.
This was supposed to be the Road Warriors here defending their title. However, a plane cancellation, Atlanta. They're not here. Greg Gagne and Kurt Hennig volunteered to come in and wrestle these two people. This is going to be up
to a reversal here as Kurt Hennig slams gorgeous Jimmy Garvin to the mat. Garvin wanted to do it to Hennig, couldn't get the job done, and Hennig turned the table.
Rod, you know that Garvin and Regal will be claiming that title of the Road Warriors for not being in here tonight.
They already did lay claim to it when it was announced that the Road Warriors weren't here. Garvin grabbing the public address announce microphone and saying, well, the tag team championship has got to be ours. That's for someone else to rule out, not for me. Oh, a hard smash by Garvin as Regal held Kurt from outside on the apron. Chin lock.
You get that hold could be turned into the Japanese stranglehold very, very easily. And that referee better be watching Garvin because he's just the one to do it. I don't want to sound like I am prejudiced here. However, maybe I am.
The reason being there happens to be a Gagne involved inside the ring as well as outside. Oh, a tremendous knee right to the midsection of Kurt Hennig. And now Hennig is taken off to the corner, and he runs into the knee of Steve Regal, who is tagged in. Regal with a whip on Hennig. Oh, the elbow smash, and down goes Hennig like a pole.
This could be it.
Cover. Count of two. Ooh. No more.
Two and a half.
Yes, indeed. Very, very close to three. Again, the body slam. No, he turns it into a backbreaker. Regal on Hennig. Again, a two count, but no more. And Greg Gagne aches to get in that ring. He can't make it. His partner taking all kinds of punishment, first from Regal, then from Garvin. Garvin drops Kurt Hennig on that top rope right on his throat. And now here you have a quick cover, a hook of the leg, a count of one. A count of one is all Garvin can get. Kurt Hennig trying to get it back. Moving very, very quickly. Garvin hanging on. Hennig struggling, trying to get over to his tag team partner, Greg Gagne. They're that close.
The struggle continues. You see the look of determination on Curt Hennig's face. You see the hand of Greg Gagne reaching in. And now you saw Steve Regal entering.
Garvin has Hennig tied up in that with that left arm of his, tied up, trying to work it into a hammerlock by Garvin. Switches now, bars the arm, going to try to pull Hennig back over his shoulders, gets it.
He has one shoulder down, the other one is still a couple of inches off the mat. You see Greg Gagne straining every muscle to get in. I believe they could have made the tag there for a moment, but Kurt just didn't see the opportunity.
There he got that tag.
There's the tag. In comes Greg Gagne. Gagne, he drills Steve Regal. And now Garvin gets a little bit of the same treatment. Three times to the head. And now to the top turnbuckle. Regal is in. Gagne sees him coming. And bingo! Gagne has Garvin. Kurt Hennig has Steve Regal. Are they going to meet in the center of the ring? Yes, they are. And down they go, crashing to the canvas. Greg Gagne, you see him from that second rope, coming down squarely on the forehead of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. The precious one is over at ringside, and she cannot bear seeing what's happening inside that ring and gives a lecture to Greg Gagne. How much of this Greg is going to take? I don't know. Look at her. How much could you take, Vern?
Well, when you're in that ring, you're being harassed from the outside.
Tremendous shoulder block.
There's not a lot of it you want to take.
Tremendous shoulder block to the midsection of Greg Gagne. And now Steve Regal continues to work. But Gagne fires back with a left and right to the midsection. He went upstairs. But a tremendous body slam by Regal. Here he comes. An elbow smash is on the way. But Gagne rolls out of the way and tags in Curt Hennig, the 235-pounder out of Robbinsdale. Look at that drop kick. Look at that shot. Curt Hennig aroused and in the center of that ring, wanting to work over Steve Regal, and go to work he does. Regal is tagged in. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, there is the head knocker, and stars are shining all over the place. One, a count of two. Garvin just about had bought the farm. However, he had enough to kick out. What a tremendous match here, ladies and gentlemen. All-Star Wrestling body slam from the top rope comes Greg Gagne flying down, the flying body slam, a count of 2.5. Oh, I thought he had him. How in the world Garvin could get out of it, I don't know, but get out of it he did. Here he comes again, and here's the sleeper hold. The sleeper hold patented by the Gagnes. Father Vern Gagne watching his son Greg Gagne puts it on Jimmy Garvin. Can he hold it? Can he put him away?
He's got to get him back off balance, back this way, Greg. If Greg can get his balance back and pull Garvin back, he'll have him.
Regal comes in.
Hennig cuts him off.
At the pass.
I didn't. What was
spray it? In the eyes of Greg
Gagne. He got
Gagne.
Sprayed. What was
Precious.
That?
Sprayed the aerosol can into the eyes.
Gagne.
And now the victory roll and the cover here by Jimmy Garvin on a totally blind Greg Gagne. And referee Jim Mitchell says the match is awarded to the combination of Jimmy Garvin and Steve Regal. But you see Greg Gagne still reeling around the ring as it was Precious, the ballet of Jimmy Garvin, spraying the aerosol can into the eyes of Greg Gagne and totally blinding him. He could not see what was coming or from what direction it was coming. Wally Carbo is now quickly into the ring, and he is talking with referee Jim Mitchell. He wants to find out exactly what the ruling of Jim Mitchell is, and will this ruling stand or not? Will it stand? My broadcast colleague, Vern Gagne, has now gone into the ring, and he too is talking to referee Jim Mitchell. Mitchell now going over and conferring with Greg Gagne, who is still blinded by it all. Greg Gagne cannot see. Greg Gagne is totally blinded from that aerosol spray can. The decision has been reversed. Ladies and gentlemen, the decision on orders from promoter Wally Carbo has been reversed, and the winners of this match by disqualification
are Craig Gagne and Curt Hennig over the combination of Steve Regal and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And we no doubt have not heard the last of this as Greg Gagne continues to be blinded and being led from the ring by his father, Vern Gagne, referee Jim Mitchell, and his tag team partner, Curt Hennig. Holy cow. Timeout for this.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, I want to remind you that next card, Sunday, September 29th, right here at the St. Paul Science Center. All right, guys, all the way from Japan. Guys, bye-bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Liberace. With a special 40th anniversary concert performance with the world-renowned London Philharmonic Orchestra. All the magic, all the music of this historic anniversary performance has been captured on this unique two-record set, Liberace's 40th anniversary album. This collection includes classic concert performances from Tchaikovsky to Beethoven, Chopin to Rachmaninoff, as well as contemporary favorites from Gershwin's I Got Rhythm to New York, New York. You'll get more than 40 classic performances, more than 90 entertaining minutes on two records or long play cassette. Liberace and the London Philharmonic. The 40th Anniversary Collection, available only if you order now.
Credit card and COD customers, call toll-free 800-358-5858. That's 800-358-5858. Or save COD fees by sending $11.98 to Liberace, P.O. Box 2880, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. That's Liberace, P.O. Box 2880, Grand Central Station, New York, New York. Please specify records, 8-track, or cassette tape.
Exclusive Saturday Night CFA Game of the Week features flashy Heisman hopeful Reggie Depard when Southern Methodist battles TCU in a battle of total offense leaders. The Horned Frogs counter with hard-nosed Southwest Conference-style defense. It's television's best live game of the day, only on ESPN.
She looks so sweet and she is so deadly. That is gorgeous Jimmy Garvin's valet, Precious, and you saw what happened. At that time, we wanted to talk to Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig. It was just plain impossible. We could not do it. An excellent night of wrestling this Tuesday night. Sergeant Slaughter and Boris Zukov, that is a war that is going to continue and continue. I don't see anything being settled there in the near future. And, of course, you saw what happened. Precious interfering in the match. Light heavyweight champion Steve Regal and Jimmy Garvin against Greg Gagne and Curt Hennig. Next week, you will see Stan the Lariat Hansen in action right here on AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN. And we will have Larry Zbyszko's In This Corner segment with his guest, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. I'm Larry Nelson. I'll see you next week.